Good morning, students. Myself, Pavan Kumar, lecturer in electronics, MVNJS and RVR College, Malkipuram. These courses belongs to final BSc electronics students in semester 5, paper 5B, consumer electronics paper. In this class, the topic is air conditioners. So what is meant by air conditioner? First of all, introduction of air conditioning. Definition. Air conditioning is the process of altering the properties of air, primarily temperature and humidity, to more favorable conditions. The definition of the air conditioning is the process of alter the properties of air. In air, you have to observe two different properties, either temperature or humidity, to more favorable conditions. We have to maintain in our comfortable conditions. This is the air conditioning systems. The control of these conditions may be desirable to maintain the health and comfort of the occupants, or to meet the requirements of industrial processes irrespective of the external climatic conditions. You have to control these air processing systems may be desirable to maintain the health and comfort of the occupants. Who will occupy the surrounding areas? You have to feel about the comfortable, or to meet the requirements of industrial process irrespective of external climate conditions. You need to maintain in medical applications, like maintain a low temperature or high temperature of the laboratories. You have to comfortable to correct or suggestible conditions. These are the controlling systems in air conditioning process. The principle of air conditioning, the goal is keep it more comfortable inside the house than it outside. The main principle of the air conditioning is you have to look at or observe the compare of two temperatures, that means inside and outside of the house or room. It is more comfortable than the outside, because you have to maintain a low temperature or high temperature in comfortable manner by using these air conditioning systems. There are several air conditioning systems are available today. There is the window air conditioning system and split air conditioning system and centralized air conditioning system and packaged air conditioning systems. These are the different types of air conditioning systems. Which one is you have to choose, because of every air conditioning system has special features depending upon the furniture and depending upon the room volume of the room and depending upon the budget and depending upon the requirement, how much of space we have to condition, how much of space we have to maintain a temperature. Depending upon these factors, we have to choose which one you have to suitable for us. First of all, we have to discuss what is meant by window air conditioning system. Window air conditionings are the one of the most commonly used and cheapest type of air conditioners. Window air conditioners are the very cheap and best air conditioner systems. These are the most commonly used air conditioning systems. To install one of these units, you need to space to make a slot in the wall, and there should also be some open space behind the wall. You have to install, for example, you have to install a windows air conditioning system. The unit of the air conditioning system is putting on the slot of the wall. You have to maintain the slot of the wall, and there should also be some open space behind the wall. This is the installation requirement in our house or room. window air conditioning units are reliable and simple to install solution to keep a room cool while avoiding the costly construction of the central air conditioning system. Because the window air conditioning system has only one unit, that means either we are using entire processing, we have to converting maintain air room temperature, either high temperature or low temperature, we have to maintain this single unit only. That's why you have to, as compared with this windows air conditioning to other conditioning, that means central air conditioning system, this is constructive and very expensive compared with the windows. Because the central air conditioning units are separately, you have to discuss in later what is meant by central air conditioning system. Better yet, when the summer heat dies down, these units can be easily removed for storage. And you can use window sill for other purpose. This is the main, this is the advantage for windows air conditioning system. You have to use in summer only. These units are can be easily removed from the storage where we have to put the wall. And the you can use window sill for other purpose also. Look at the infrastructure or units of the window air conditioning system. This window air conditioning system has only one unit we have to put in the wall in outside of the inside and outside of the room. In this way you have to install this conditioning. You can observe the what are the components are inbuilt in the outdoor or indoor unit. That means we have to inside or outside of the room. You have to maintain the total unit, that is a compressor. You have to maintain units, we'll discuss here. Compressor, condenser, that means condenser coils, compressor, expansive valve, and cooling coils are there, indoor and outdoor units are. Expansive valve as is my indoor unit. The boiler cooled air is inside the room, and compressor and condenser are the outdoor units like fan also. You have the layout diagram of the windows air conditioning system. This is the main components of the air conditioning system: compressor, evaporator, expansive valve, and condenser. These are the main basic main parts of the air conditioning system, that is the components of the air conditioning system. So first of all, we have to discuss what is the main refrigeration process in air conditioning system. Refrigeration is a process of converting either high temperature to low temperature depending upon the room temperature, which it has different stages, that means the cycle, cooling cycle. You can observe the layout diagram and cooling cycle of the refrigeration process. These are the main four components: compressor and condenser and expansive valve and evaporator. And I will discuss later. You have the process. What is the process of refrigeration cycle process? You can observe the evaporator, cooled air. These are the inside of the room. That you can put on the inside of the evaporator and observe the room air. This is converted into vapor, that means mechanical compressor. This mechanical compressor will send and compress the room temperature, room air, and which is pass it to the condenser. Which is a mechanical compressor, they compress the air in the form of condenser. Condenser may be water cooled or air cooled. The vapor will be changed into the water, that means steam liquid. These liquid is travel through the high temperature. These liquid also travel to the expansive valve. The expansive valve to separate and travels through the liquid plus vapor, which is traveling to the same of evaporator. This is the main equipment for main component for refrigeration cycle, evaporator. This liquid and vapor is converted into cold air. In this way, the refrigerant process will be observe that where evaporator, compressor, and condenser and expansion valve. For example, you can observe the evaporator liquid turns to vapor, cold air flows out room. These are the process of each component. You can also observe these refrigerant process in evaporator and receiver, compressor and condenser and expansive valves. Typical single stage vapor compressor refrigeration, expansive valve and condenser and compressor and warm air, that means evaporator. You can observe the warm air means the room temperature will be observed by the evaporator. That is the expansive valve, that means compressor. The evaporator can send the room temperature, room air, and that means warm air into the compressor. That means in the form of vapor. The compressor compresses the vapor into the high temperature into the condenser. The condenser also condensation process in the form of vapor is in the form of liquid. The liquid is expansive through the expansive valve, which is travel through the expansive valve, which is converted into liquid plus vapor. And finally, in the evaporator evaporation, the process of converting liquid plus vapor, which is in the form of cold air. This is the cold air is entered into the inside of the room. This is the entire refrigeration process. The coolant. Heat is removed from the cooling by coolant. We have to use the coolant in refrigeration process. Heat is in air conditioning systems. Heat is removed from the cooling by coolant. Functions as heat absorber from the evaporator. Good coolant must have features. You have to observe a good coolant, non-toxic, not explosive, non-corrosive components. These are the main feature of the coolants. Not expensive, soluble in oil to lubricant effectively. You have to repair or install any new one. Easy to remove or easy to install and easy to rectify the problems. Harmful when responding to oil even the presence of nature. Have a high resistance to the electricity. These are the main characteristics of the coolant. These are the look at the different types of coolants used in the air conditioning systems can you and refrigerators. Can you find the where to use the each of these coolants in refrigerators like R22 monopolaridic chloromethanol and R11 and R12. These are the different types of coolants used in refrigerators. So in this class we have to in this class I can discuss in what are the types of air conditioners, what is mean by air conditioning and types of air conditioners, and what is mean by window air conditioning, which is the better kind of air conditioning you have to choose your comfortable to manner, because it has a lot of units in central air conditioning system. But single unit air conditioning system is window air conditioning system as compared with the central air conditioning system, the most and costly expensive than the central air conditioning is expensive than the window air conditioning system, because a lot of units are there in central air conditioning system. We have to maintain, the main reason is we have to maintain a room temperature or any house or any buildings are, we have to maintain a comfortable manner, we have to maintain a temperature in comfortable manner. These are the different types of, we have to choose different types of air conditioning systems. So this is the topic of air conditioning systems. So we have to compare, for example, we have to compare central air conditioning or window air conditioning or split air conditioning system. We have to maintain. Generally air conditioning systems are either cooling or heating systems. In general, airing and heating systems are also available in the market. Those are the HVAC air conditioning system, heating and ventilation and air conditioning systems. In this HVAC systems, they have two different refrigeration cycle processing, because you have to maintain high temperature and low temperature also. That means heat system and cooling system are there. In heating system, we have to maintain, if we have to maintain a high temperature for as compared with the surrounding temperature, then we will use to heating source. How can maintain a heat in the room temperature? If we can use, for example, types of heating systems are there, we have to use HVAC systems. We have to divide heating and cooling systems are there, all water air conditioning systems and all air conditioning systems. If you have to use all water air conditioning systems, we have to heat some water which travels through the pipelining. That means we have to use pumping through the pipelining. This hot water will travel to the room temperature. Then also we have to maintain room temperature is high, low temperature to high temperature. Then the room temperature is also low. Then it absorbs the heat from hot water. Then this after heating is lost water, then which is entering into the water chamber also. And again this process is start, and this water is also again heating, and this water is travel to the by pumping to the pumps and then entering to the room. This process is continuously maintain the high temperature as compared with the surrounding temperatures. They have to maintain these heating systems also, and also we have to maintain cooling system. That means, for example, air conditioning system, we have to maintain room temperature is low as compared with the surrounding temperatures. In this system, we have to observe, for example, we have to use water air conditioning system. That means hydronic water air conditioning system. That means cooling system. We have to, this cool water is cooled by chillers. We have to use chillers, then water is cooled by the, then travel into the room by the pumping or to the pipeline. Since it is the entering to the room, we have to maintain the high temperature, low temperature of the room, because it is already high temperature, which is cooled by the low temperature water, which is absorbed room temperature heat, then it travel to the return duct as to the same as through the water. And again this process is completely refrigeration cycle process, because you have to maintain a low temperature as compared with the outside of the room. In this is the way for converting high temperature. You have to maintain comfortable manner high temperature or low temperature. The air conditioning systems are very useful to us in our daily life. So this is the class. We have to maintain air conditioning system for useful. Any different applications in air conditioning system, we have to maintain medical, especially medical applications, because we have to maintain or we have to restrict the medicines are in high temperature or low temperatures. In medical factories are very, and ice factories are also useful for air refrigeration process. Yeah, they have to use in air chillers. Then you need to maintain, for example, windows air conditioning system are used to small room only or single room only. Split air conditioning systems are used to one or two more rooms only, and windows and second finally. And central air conditioning systems are used to, for example, theaters, shopping malls and restaurants, like hospitals. These are the applications used in central air conditioning system. And finally, packaged air conditioning system. The packaged air conditioning system also very useful, as because the packaging means if the total components like compressor and expansion valve and condenser and evaporators are packaging and what a single unit behaves like a single packing unit. That's why the important for packaging unit, they have to use small areas like small function halls. The several types of air conditioning systems are there in the available in market. The different companies are also fabricate this type of air conditioners, provides the cheapest and maintain the comfortable maintenance of the comfortable temperature. This is the class for. Thank you.